Philippine stock market trading was delayed Wednesday due to technical issues, a day after the New York Stock Exchange also suffered an opening bell glitch. PSE trading only started shortly after 10 in the morning. For the day, the PSE index finished up by a little over 0.5% to settle at 7081 ahead of the release of fourth quarter and full year 2022 GDP data out on Thursday. Security Bank's Dan Rosses sees GDP hitting 7.5% for the full year of 2022, the top end of government's target range, and moderating to 6.3% this year. He also expects a total of 50 basis point hike by the central bank this year, followed by a long pause and then a rate cut by early 2024.
Already accounts for some slowdown in terms of consumption. But all the other indicators, we have very good FDI pledges already. So that will be good in the I part, not the one that you said, that's the investment side. Mm-hmm. Government spending could probably be flattish. Trade could be better, probably in the second half with China reopening. No? So all those, there are offsetting factors. It's going to be bumpy in the first half, but we're more bullish towards the second half.
In corporate stories, ACEN begins constructing the 300-megawatt Palawig 2 solar farm in Zambales. The project, including the construction of the 1,200-megawatt transmission line, is estimated to cost 16 billion pesos. It's expected to produce over 400 gigawatts of clean energy per year, and together with Palawig 1 Solar's 90 gigawatt, can power around 139,000 homes and save 350,000 tons of carbon emissions every year. The Philippines aims to achieve a 35% renewable energy share in the power generation mix by 2030. Michelle Long, ABS-CBN News.